Hey humans, I'm AndyTheDead and I'm back with some more Windbound. This time we have some goals. We have to build a better boat, specifically a full wooden one, and also, you know, hunt, search, explore, and finish the chapter. Now let's get going. Alright, we just began the fourth chapter, island straight up ahead. Alright, let's see what we have here, and let's hope that the game will not crash once again. Right, we can see some trees, some animals. Yeah, this island will be bountiful. Let's get to collecting stuff. Yeah, my axe is not doing very well. We are going to need to find a gloom harrow, was it? Yeah, I think so. Right, this might be a problem. Right, let's get to hunting. One Gorhor down, one more to go. There we go, easy stuff. Also, let's hunt some blinks here. We're going to need those for their feathers, so we can make arrows. And we found the money obelisk, that's always good. Yeah, just 150. It's useful. Let's just hope that when we finish the chapter, we're going to get a blessing upgrade. You know, an extra slot or whatever it's called. And now I think we have enough items to make... yeah, the wooden boat. Or at least most parts of it. So let's get to that. There she is, our new boat. She looks great. Also, we could do some more upgrades to the hulls, but yeah, let's leave that for now. First, we've got to dismantle our old boat. There we go, she's ready and beautiful. We also have to find some wood in order to build some spikes and keep it safe. Alright then. Can we see anything in the horizon from here? No, doesn't look like it. I guess we're going to have to get to exploring. Let's get moving, but first let's save. Also, yes, let's build an anchor. This is going to be useful. There we go. So I don't have to crash my boat into the beach every time we reach an island. Fantastic. Time to move ahead. Oh, this goes really fast. Yeah, that's nice. I can see something over there. Let's get to that. Yeah, it's an island, surrounded by lots and lots of rocks. And also there in the distance we can see the causeway for the keys. Right, let's park the boat here. Wait, isn't the anchor working? Doesn't look like it. And the meat is ready. Fantastic, let's get to some more cooking. And let's manage our stuff. You're going to need the axe. Yeah, take the hammer as well. Take the almost bad meat, the bone arrows. Anything else? Yeah, let's get the skin so we can tan it. And let's leave behind some items. And we've got some rotten food as well, yeah, that definitely not good. So let's drop it. Let's get to exploring and hopefully finding a Gloomharrow so we can build a new axe. Well, there doesn't seem to be much on this island. Oh, lots of bamboo. Yeah, we can build some spikes for the boat from that. Is that? No, that's the Planeswalker. Let's get it while it's sleeping. Dick move, I know, but what's it gonna do? It's better me killing it than it killing me. Come on. Where are you? There you go. Let's move in for the kill. Well, not with a knife though. Yeah, much better. Also, we should build a figurehead. What does the Planeswalker figurehead do? A field of lightning. Yeah, that sounds nice, but oh, we need the Storm's Eye gem, which we actually have. Oh, it's the gems, not the items we get from the animals. Right, all right. And the health rock, yeah. Could we also get a stamina rock? It would be much more helpful right now. And is this the last use of my axe? It sure was. Right, that's not good. I explored most of this island, took all I could except for one single tree that I couldn't chop down because my axe broke. Also, I didn't find a key shrine. That probably means that more islands generate with each chapter, and yeah, that's actually really, really good. Alright, let's get moving to the next island. I'll see you there unless something funny happens on the way there. There it is in the distance among Groks and treacherous waters. Another key shrine. And hopefully a Gloomharrow, please, maybe, perhaps, possibly? Yes? No? Let's find out. This island looks a little bit strange and a mist settled in. Is that bad? That's usually bad. Right, let's get to explore. Don't crash on the rocks. Stop right. There you go. All scheduled up. Ooh, this island looks spooky. Oh, that was poisonous. Fuck. All right, this is Tripping Island. And what? Oh, those are mushrooms. Yeah, have some. I don't know if my way of thinking is right or wrong, but this island is very gloomy, so maybe perhaps Gloomharrow? No Gloomharrow yet, but we found something to mine. Crude metal. And we've got, yeah, metal things, metal spear. Oh, that sounds sexy. But we didn't get metal tip arrows. And more mining. I'm going to have to build, yeah, a clay kiln, yes, to smelt the metal, I guess. The music gets weird. What the hell is that? End that. Well, holy freak. Do I want to fight that? Just let me get my stuff and I'll be on my way. And oh, you're in for a battle. Yeah, screw that. No. Holy freak, that looks And I'm out of arrows. Let's see if I can build some real quick. Yeah, just for... Ooh boy. Holy... Where did it go? I just killed that giant thing. And it flew into space. Game, you're starting to break in the Sims. Seriously though, where did it go? Is it still flying? Ah well, bad luck I guess. Oh, this is a poisonous bubble thingy. Let's try and avoid that. Oh, are those silk moves? Yeah, they sure are. Well, our adventures on this island haven't gone too well since we didn't find a gloom harrow, we don't have an axe, and that giant armored animal we killed decided that its people need it and flew off. Let's get the key then and get going. Cloaked in darkness, we give in to our bloodlust. Nice. There we go, made it back to the boat and we're ready to move on with our adventure. But I've realized that we never gave our boat a name, you know, since that's something that people do with their boats. Let's call the boat Artemis, the goddess of the hunt. And yeah, since Kara is kind of a hunter as well, I think it's fitting. Also, before we leave, I built a plane soldier figurehead. Yeah, it looks menacing. I love it. And we've got crabs. On the boat, I mean. Don't take this out of context. So I sailed a little bit to the south, but I can see nothing over in that direction. But we found some strange rock formations over there, just like we did in the last chapter. Where it had just a bunch of money, if I remember correctly. Or something like that. Let's find out. There we go. Let's get exploring. But do I have my glider? No, I didn't have one, but I can build one. Yeah, let's do that. Right, let's get to exploring this place. Oh, we've got a bunch of bone arrows along with the money. That's always good. Yeah, and a sea shard obelisk. Right, nothing more from what I can see. Off we go, and I think we can already see our next destination. It's right over straight ahead. Yeah, because we've already been in on this island. It was the gloomy one. We might have to return to that. And it's another key shrine island. Yeah, that's lovely. Except that the key shrine is not on the island, it's right next to it. That doesn't seem to be a problem, to be honest. There, park the boat and only hit it just a bit. Does this need repairs? At some point, yeah. These sacred islands are our home. We will not abandon them. Yeah, but you did something to anger the sea gods, so... If you didn't want to abandon them, they killed you. Right, let's explore a bit. I don't have my axe with me. And those are silk modes. Yeah, let's deal with you real fast. Right, there's nothing much interesting here except for a bunch of silk moss and yeah, some trees I can't chop down. Let's move on ahead. There doesn't seem to be anything else in this western part of the map. Right up here is where we deliver the keys. Let's explore the east side. And we found an island that has some strange rocks in front of it. Or rather, somewhere around it. And again with the mist. Fantastic. Let's slow this down a bit. Let's slow this down a lot. Right. Once again, it's a gloomy island, so if we heal that big armored thing, yeah, let's hope it will not decide to fly off again. Alright, we have some of those mosquitoes bumblers. This is the the poisonous biome with the bubbles that burst and gives us poison. And also silk moss. Could we also please find some bones so I can build more arrows? And we found something that looks a lot like a graveyard. Am I wrong? Oh, all of these have some things to say. We've forever grieved her death. She has fought for us until her last breath. Mourn not this poor soul, for they have found peace beyond these raging storms. In life she taught us the beauty of song, in death, of silence. Goodbye, my friend. In times of great deprivation, you always maintained a big heart. Husband, I will find you again in the heaven beyond heaven. Lots of people died, eh? Dear mother, time took that which turmoil and tragedy could not. A hero lies here who has died protecting his family from the great storms. Luana, loving wife, mother, and courageous hunter of cell spirits. Grandmother, she still remembered better times. Times before, they lived this world with her. Right. So, everyone's dead? And are we going to be dead soon, given that we found another one of these things? Oh, it's Omi. And it spits poison. Not now, bees. Or mosquitoes or whatever the flip you are. Right, so the mosquito is gone. But now we have to deal with the frog, was it, I think. You just wait there, I'm going to pick up some items and I'm coming for you. Oh, there's a lot of metal here. Oh well, is there something here? Oh, just a dead thingy. And a village. Broken huts and whatnot. Right, let's hope. Canoes lie abandoned in piles on the beach, decomposing under the hot sun's gaze. We dare not take them out again. Yeah, because you angered the sea gods. Are there any arrows here? The finest taste, sizzling by the fire, will not go down to waste. Nothing left to desire. Right. And a sentinel soul gem. It was the storm tempest gem that I used for the figurehead. Sail spirits of the sea, once our friends, now meals to be. Save our souls, slaying infinity. Am I supposed to do something with all this? Yeah, probably. And I think I found another health altar. Yeah, let's use this. Although I would very much appreciate a stamina altar. Shrine, yeah, excuse me. So my spear decided to break down and yeah, now I'm armed with nothing but arrows and a basic stick spear. And of course my knife, in order to take that giant frog thing out. Come on, die. There you go. I don't seem to be able to find the giant frog monster. Perhaps it flew off to find its friend from the other island. Yeah, where could... Is that it? No, this is just the bunch of pots from the burned village. Poison glands. Can we make something with it? Perhaps poison arrows? No, we don't seem to get a recipe. Wait a minute, I think I can hear it over here. There it is. Oh, flip. Don't you fart on me. Yeah, stay there. Stay. No, don't turn around. Well, that was a headshot, so. Thank you, I guess. I'm out of arrows. Let's move in for the kill. There we go. Don't fly off. Yeah. Down you go. And what did you get from the cell fragment? Scale hull armor. Yeah, that's going to be nice. And poison glands. And 5 arrows back. Right, so yeah, I think we did all we could on this island. Except perhaps for... yeah, the destroyed village. I'm thinking there is a riddle here. Well, if there is a riddle, I'm going to think about it while we travel along with our boat. So it's time to move further east and then back down south. And wait a minute, I think we found the secret. From sunrise to sunset, we will never give up. We will always protect our island homes. From sunset to sunrise, no sails will do us harm. Yeah, can we please park the boat here? Are these things riddles or just backstory? I don't know. Oh, the figurehead. Yeah, it was hitting something. Right, it's time to get out of here. And we found a tiny little island over here. And the third key shrine. Yeah, those are very close by, so let's check them out. We still have to go south this way. And on the little tiny island are some pots. Yeah, containing mostly sea shards. I don't see anything else here. Right, let's get moving. Also, before we get to the sea shrine, the key shrine, rather, island, I see something over there. Yeah, let's check it out. It looks like a weirdly shaped tree, but weirdly shaped trees in video games usually hold secrets. Alright, just a couple of pots containing money. Nothing else I can say. Right, let's go get that key piece. The music has changed a bit. Is something happening? You know, except from... the weather turning bad and all that. Made it to the island, but it looks very, very small. Yeah. Possibly silk moss, pigs. And just that. Let's find out. Yeah, I was definitely right about the silk moss. Made it to the top of the shrine. Let's get the key. The war rages on. One day our children will remember us as saviors. or destroyers, the ones who condemn them. Yeah, the island was just silk, moss, sticks, grass and trees that I can't chop down because we haven't found a gloom harrow yet. That's bad. I'm guessing I'm going to find one on the last island I'm going to explore, and then I'm going to have to go around all the islands again. Oh boy. It's time to move further south. There we go, we found our next destination, another small looking island. That's not good. It's right here in the middle. It has a lot of silk moss. Also possibly blinks. There are lots of silk moss nests here. And a money obelisk. Yeah, let's get that and get the freak out of here. I don't want to fight any more silk moss. I have enough. What do you call it? Silk threads, as it is. Silk moss, grass, palm fronds, and yeah, that's just about it. Let's move on to the next island. I couldn't find much else down on this south area of the map, so I'm guessing we're going to have to go and deliver the keys, which is sad that we couldn't find a gloom harrow so we can make an axe. But what can you do? Alright, made it to the show, delivered the keys, and we're ready to learn more about our story. Someone conquered the... yeah, the sea monster. And it obeyed him. But this guy has different colors from the others before. Is this Kara? And they decided to fight it again. The fourth crossing sorrow. Oh, come on, now you have... I am sure that this is about grief, alright? I will explain more next time. Alright. So, if he finds this pinecone thingy, he finds a bunch of them, and decides to fight the monster. Right. I'm guessing the last mural will help us make sense of all of this. Are these the magical seashells they mentioned before that they were worshipping? Let's find out. Let's go through the fourth crossing. I'm guessing this one is going to be really, really difficult. At first we meet our Kraken friend. Maybe I should slow down a bit. Let's pick up some speed. Oh, rocks. Let's slow this down a lot. And reefs as well. I'm guessing we're going to have to face the crab lobster thingies that jump off the reefs and mess up with our boat. Yeah, this crossing is going to be a lot longer than the previous one. lots of reefs. And sharks as well. Yeah, that's what we need. Yeah. What's next? Someone throwing rocks at me? No. Alright, I think this is the last part of this crossing. Screw you, jellyfish. Please don't destroy my boat, jellyfish. No, that wasn't the last part. We have one more. I'm guessing the Kraken will appear again. No, doesn't look like it. Made it through in one piece. Yeah, that's great. We have to choose between Gortle's Grid, that gives us more sea shards from whenever we find the sea shard, and the double one, Hester's Kelp Helper. Fruit and vegetables take longer to degrade and regenerate more health when eaten. Let's buy this one, but I'm not going to activate it because, yeah, I already have two blessings that I like. Alright, those pinecone looking thingies are the blessings. So the mural tried to tell us that we have to collect all the blessings we can so we can face the Kraken monster that we used to worship and have angered. Right. I'm guessing since the next one is the last chapter, we're going to find out. The last Shell Spirit. So, first thing first, the game crashed 3 more times. Apparently, all of this is too much to handle for Nintendo Switch. But that wasn't a problem, it just took me a lot longer to record this part. Now, I'm very excited about how the game picks up the pace with the story. I'm pretty sure that I'm spot on about the grief thing, because up until now we have seen the 4 stages of grief, maybe named otherwise, and I would bet good money that the next crossing is going to be named acceptance. I don't know yet, but I am absolutely certain that's the case. Now, concerning resources and islands to explore, yeah, even though there were more in the last chapter than the previous, there still wasn't enough. Something must be done about this. There are just not enough resources. I couldn't find A gloom harrow to make an axe. Sure, I killed a new monster and it died in a pretty funny way. It flew off into space. But yeah, still it was enough. Maybe I'm doing something wrong, I don't know. Anyway, we're going to pick up chapter 5 next time. Until then, stay safe and have fun.